So listen to the voice of God. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. So he can send somebody to come in the name of the Lord. And all the rest, so as I was descending, all of a sudden I was taken out of there. And while I was taken out of there, I noticed something. There are some words I always say, wisdom will not leave me the word of the dead. Wisdom has brought me back to life. Wisdom will not leave me the word of the dead. And all the rest. And the wisdom of God is Jesus himself. Okay, in another section again, I was on my way to hell. Okay, maybe we might make this the last. I will not read any other chapter from here. But I think I'm true with the heavenly, the spiritual. True with the heavenly one. Okay, we'll take the last. I was on my way to hell. Like I said, ensure that the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 10:12, be careful where you think you stand, lest you fall. There is no security for any man, like you must make it to heaven, like something like, because you have been preaching the word. We must always humble ourselves before his presence. I was in the spirit, and then I saw the angels of God, two of them. When I saw the angels, they were with many books. I saw the book of... They opened different books to me. I saw the book of tithing and offering. Let me just tell you this simple secret. One of the greatest secrets to not have lack is tithe and offering. I'm not saying that, you know, because of myself. I'll leave your church very soon. And your pastor has not told me anything. But I'm saying that to help yourself as a church, so that you can also prosper just as your soul prospers. It's not unscriptural. Just that people take the messages outside. Because when I was there, I saw a book that was open. In this book is the book of tithe and offering. And I saw that by God's grace, I've been good with that. Another book was open, the book of evangelism. The book of soul winning, sorry. I saw the number of souls I had won in the space of how many years? That was, is it like 2 years or 3 years? It was in thousands. I won't call its number. I don't tell people the number, but it was in its thousands. You see, you don't need to preach on the pulpit. You can do money cry and get many more souls for Jesus. You can go to the bus. You don't need to preach on the pulpit. You can do it. These are even the people that God looks at very much well. Because those ones, they have a greater reward. I can tell you that. Forget about what you see in the church or in ministries. Those that preach in the buses and that share tracts in the office, those small, they do it in the rural areas. On that, God looks upon very much well. Because I believe I was doing that very much well in my early years and all the rest. And if you are faithful in little, God will give you more. If you are not faithful in little, God cannot give you more. That's the secret. And so the book was open. I saw the number of souls there. Another book was open again. In that book that was open is the book of prayer. I saw the number of hours, the number of minutes and seconds. It was written like that, that I had prayed on the earth. They are taking note of it. So that's what I saw there. And it was good. Good pass mark. Then another book was open, the book of life. And my name was not there. And it's very funny. And I was crying to the Lord. Why is my name not here? I was crying to the Lord, why is my name not here? I have done your will and I think I've preached. And I don't tell the Lord, but I've preached now. I've traveled. And why is it that my name is not here and all the rest? They say, Chilo's here. We cannot allow you to enter into heaven right now. If you die right now, just the same way the angel said to me, if you die right now, you will not make it to heaven. Hey, wow. And I began to cry. I was crying, Lord, have mercy on me. And they told me then, my fasting life is too low. And then I was surprised, fasting, what has fasting got to do with my inheritance and all the rest? Like I said again, sin is disobedience to the Spirit of God. So it might be sin to me, it might not be sin to you. What it means is that God might be telling me, because For you to walk in some level of spiritual authority, you have to fast and pray. Because you'll be hindering some people that have been tied to you if you don't do and pay those sacrifices. There are many things that will not happen in your ministry life if God has sent you for a purpose. I didn't talk about the last day army of Jesus. I didn't talk about the last day prophet and some certain things. If I get there, you understand that this last day army, they have spiritual figures. If you don't pay some certain price, people will not come to the kingdom like that. Not that it is by your power. God will give you the grace. So, if you don't obey the word of the Lord that tells you to do all those things, you will hinder some people from getting blessed. So, it was almost like my own kind of story. And they said my fasting life was too low. And I was crying. I was asking, Lord, have mercy on me. What I noticed about God is that I know that God is very good to me and merciful to me and also good to you and merciful to us. I noticed that anytime he sees that I want to stumble, he will just have to call me somehow. Many times like that. Whenever I want to stumble, he just call me. Chenos, hey, I don't want to. It's like he's always saving my soul, you know, from the pit. That's why David said, my Lord, will not allow me to go deep into the world of the dead. My Lord will always save me. So that's how he's doing to his children. If you have a humble heart, a contrite heart, a humble spirit, a heart that seeks to serve Jesus, God will be protecting you like this. He will not allow you to get to hell. But now that I've known Jesus, now that I've found love in Jesus, now that I've known Jesus, I believe with Jesus, you'll definitely get to heaven in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And that's how it happens. And the angel told me to do some number of days of fasting at that point in time. And I did that, and God restored me. And then God brought me back to his presence. Okay, that's the end for this all. But you get this in the book and in the CD, which is free by the grace of God. I pray that the word that we have heard today will not stand against us on the day of judgment. Have a desire to be like Jesus. 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 And God will bless your soul in Jesus' name. Let's rise up to make a little bit of prayer. We give you all that glory. We give prophesy so much in their life, but one thing I've desired for them as a church, help them to walk like Jesus, help them to be like Jesus. Remove all this rubbish holiness we see in Christendom, remove all this filthy holiness we see in Christendom, remove all this religious holiness we see in Christendom. But let your children know holiness is to follow Jesus. This I pray, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray. I love you. God bless you.